Hello everyone, Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. On this video, I'm going to discuss looper pedals. Now these are excellent devices. I think they should be a part of every serious guitar player's guitar kit at their studio. But the sad truth is that a lot of guitar players buy them and have terrible success with actually using them, you know, getting them to operate in the loop function perfectly. Now, I can understand this because the functionality of a looper pedal rests upon punching in and out as perfectly as possible. And if a guitarist's feel for timing isn't all that great, the pedal won't lie to you. It's going to relate back exactly what you put into it. But there's some good news. You know, in this video, I've got a single revolutionary tip that will solve your looper timing problems once and for all. Well, let's start by breaking down a little bit of the functionality of the looper pedals themselves. You know, the looper pedal is a fairly simple device. It's basically a switch that's going to punch your guitar part in and out of the mix that you're creating. In essence, the looper pedal is a very simple recording device, and no matter which pedal you purchase, the overall function of these loopers is going to be the same. You know, what will vary is the length of time that a pedal will record for, also the number of foot switches for punching in new loop segments, and how many layers you'll be able to place one over the other. You know, more expensive looper pedals, like, you know, sort of like the Cadillac of them all, that RC300 by Boss, they're going to even allow you to have data storage of your loops. And, you know, high-end machines like the RC300 will even allow transfer of the loops that you'll create across to your computer, where you can use them in different ways after you download them as uncompressed WAV files. Well, let's get things started by creating a loop. You know, for our demonstrations, I'm going to be using the Ditto Looper by TC Electronics. It's a very simple to use loop pedal that's also really inexpensive. The Ditto is just a single foot switch pedal with a single loop level control on the top here that provides a 5-minute loop limit with unlimited overdubs. It does not allow any storage or transfer of loops, and it has no effects. But you know, when it comes to creating loops though, with any pedal, the biggest issue is always timing. You know, the solution though is actually really simple for this issue. What you got to do is you got to run a metronome or drum machine going on in the room and play into the loop. Let me demonstrate this for you. All right, so I'm all ready to go. I got my looper pedal out. It's all plugged in. It's working perfectly. I've got my metronome out. I selected a time that I'm going to use the click track at. I understand my progression. It's going to be really straightforward. Just a 1-6-2-5 in the key of C major. So that's C major 7, A minor 7, D minor 7, and G dominant 7. So I've got a progression worked out. I've got everything ready to go. I've, you know, practiced the progression up. The next thing is I'm going to turn that metronome on, and I want to get the click track going so I understand where my feel is and where everything's at. Then the next thing is I'm going to get all prepped up, ready to go over that button there, so I know exactly when I'm going to go through the spill of chord changes and punch in. And so what I'm going to do first is count in and start my run through of the chord changes, and then on the loop of them, I'm going to snap into the looper pedal and get that thing into the mix. So here we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Listen close. On that repeat, we should be with that metronome, so it's 100%. There it is, right on the beat. And that's how you're going to get perfect loops. If you haven't got a click track or something, you know, how are you going to get a perfect loop, you know? And what you'll find also is that, I'm going to turn this off for a sec. What you'll find also is that when you perfect this, you know, when you get really on the money, that loop is going to last for a long time with that perfect click of that metronome. You know, eventually it's going to degrade because, you know, you might be 1/110th of a second off with your foot hitting that button, you know, to click it in. So eventually it'll degrade against the metronome. You know, no, we're only human. We're not, you know, robots or something. But this is the way that you get accurate loops, man. All right, so now you understand how to create a loop and get it into your loop pedal with perfect timing. The next step that you can move on to is building layers. Now, this is easy to do, and it sounds fantastic since all you're doing is going onward with your looping process and creating a new part performed on top of the part that you just created. And the process is fantastic for testing ideas that you may want to, you know, use later on or try later on in your recordings that you're going to do, or this can also be great for if you're just simply trying to enhance the sound and feel of a loop that you know you'll be jamming on for quite a while. So let's try adding a few layers on top of a part that we've already created in the loop pedal. All right, so the next idea is all about layering. Now, layering just means you've got your original loop going on. We're gonna go and tie in some new ideas over top of that just to fill things out a little bit with the loop. Now, when you do this, you're gonna have to play the loop and get it going, and then just as it starts into its cycle, or prior to that, pre-cycle, you gotta go and punch in and start, you know, putting in whatever you're gonna layer. Now, maybe what I'll do, since this is just a really simple 1-6-2-5, is I'll play some just third intervals. And a fourth maybe right at the end there. And you know, you want to practice this stuff up before you do your punch in. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the loop. So there it is going along. Not the top of it, here we go. That sounds pretty good. I know it's gonna fit. So now I can get ready to actually punch it in. And I wanna punch it in at the top of the loop. So just prior to that top, I'm gonna hit it and then go. And there it is. I got my first layer. Now I can work on something else. Maybe I could put a little melodic idea in there. You know, maybe like, try something like this, you know. I got something now. I'm gonna get, you know, get it in there. Notice how I practiced it first, and I really got it sorted out in my mind to be what it actually is, you know. So anyway, that's layering. You know, it's kind of fun because you can layer as much as you want. You can even add bass lines, you know, something low down. Pop something like that, and if you could, it's just really endless. I mean, I could just keep going and on and going and going and going over and over. And but the thing is that layering is so cool because it fattens up the part that you have on the loop pedal, and you know, you really build some cool, you know, staple ideas that you can begin having some lead work over top of with. Well, as you can tell, working with a looper is an excellent way to both test ideas that you're practicing and also to study soloing and even to work on building cool new ideas for just, you know, eventually recording your stuff in your home studio. There's so many uses, you know, maybe even you could use your looper on stage. It's just a fantastic practicing tool and one I believe that I think every guitarist needs to have as part of their home practice area. And, you know, once you can master the art of the loop, which once again involves using a metronome or drum machine, have that perfect timing dialed in and play along with a solid punch in and out. Once you're able to do that, you're going to be able to establish loops that are solid and they flow through time perfectly, and that loop is going to go around 100% for layering or for just jamming or, you know, hanging out with your favorite scales and arpeggios. Well, hey, thanks for joining me. If you'd like to find out what you should learn next on guitar, take a look at the courses over at my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. My step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced courses will cover what you need to know, along with how to be able to move forward and become the best player that you can be. I've worked on these courses since 1992, and I feel that altogether they're the best guitar program you'll ever find. The courses will help you learn to identify what's required to get you up to that next level of guitar playing in a very organized way that just simply makes sense. So I look forward to helping you further at creativeguitarstudio.com. Until next time, take care, and we'll catch up again on the next video. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.